it's sometimes a little hard to find a good match. Either it can get really one-sided, either on my end or on their end. And that's the tricky part about the whole thing. But what I've noticed about Smash players overall is that some play casually, others just play it... They're elitist. They just want to fight against the best of the best. As far back as Brawl, when I was playing those online matches, man, some of the players are elitist. I mean, to the point that they just... It's like, if you don't meet their standards, they forfeit the match. I mean, I hate that. That's just poor sportsmanship. I don't care if it's a poor internet connection or not. That just annoys me. But then again, yeah, Smash Brothers is kind of like a little awkward online. So, it can go either way. Let's go back with the mech. The mech attack. Mewtwo, huh? Bring it on. Yeah, Mewtwo has always been very counter-defensive. Really got him. Okay. No! Oh, he spiked me. All right. Let's see what else we can do here. The little mech is clearly no match for Mewtwo. Being a projectile-heavy character, I guess the one that's closest would be Samus. I'm actually pretty good with Samus, believe it or not. Oh, so he chooses Ness instead. Okay. With me. Wow. Well, gotta learn not to do that again. I'll hand it to him. He's surprisingly good with Ness.
game.
Wow. Did I see that coming? It's a little hard to, you know, when it comes to Ness, he's a very tricky character, especially with all those counters. The baseball bat, it really helps when it comes to countering projectiles all the time. Alright, let's go with DK. You sometimes have to know how to set up that wind-up punch, and the down B, which is pretty much the floor slap. Also very helpful. And I guess he's teaching me how to use a Samus properly. Yo! Another character that, that he beat. Oh, son of a... I mean, just when you think you're good, there's always going to be someone that's better. And it's going to be very... I mean, like... most of my practice usually comes from, most of my experience usually comes from Smash 64 and Melee. But sometimes these guys are just so experienced that it just... it's jaw-dropping the way these guys are good. One-on-one. I'm more of like the standard player, maybe sometimes the occasional casual player. But man, some of these guys are just good to the point that they just humiliate you to a certain degree. Let's go back as Link. One thing I should point out about the Smash Ultimate version of Link... well, he is based on the Breath of the Wild version. The disadvantage is that the... that version of Link... oh, come on, no lag. The disadvantage about that version of Link is that... it's the hookshot. Because apparently, he doesn't have the hookshot in that version, but instead he has remote bombs. So, you lose something, but you gain something new. And it's gotten a little hard for me to adapt to the new version of Link. But sure, you can make the argument saying that, well, you got Young Link and Toon Link, and they still have the hookshot. It's... I don't know, it really varies. On me now. Just waiting me. It was waiting for me to come close. had to outsmart him there. Leg is hurting. Leg is hurting. This was the type of character that was constantly measuring me, viewing my attacks, strategizing constantly. Let's see what we can do. I'm trying to think. Let's go back to Donkey Kong. Interesting choice. One, go! No! Oh, you son of a rapscallion. Be careful with that grab. I'm just looking at the gamepad. Ha! it up. Got him! Lag is killing me. Freaking lag! I'm not gonna get screwed over here. Interferes, that could be an issue. I know, it's mostly bobbing and weaving at this point. All the dodging. Come on. Got him. Boy, it was a tedious match. It was kind of slow and tedious, I'll say that. It's like he was waiting for me to attack so that he could counter. He was trying to see what moves I would make. He wanted to see if I would screw up. I don't know.